I guess I should start off saying filming's pretty much my life. No other way to put it except that filming is my life. My life is like a movie. I guess I should start off saying filming's pretty much my life. You know, ever since I was 3 years old, I got the passion for filming, you know? Be it reciting movies word for word, watching it dozens and dozens of times. As a kid, I was always repeating movies, always reciting them.
No, don't do that! Don't do that! We are hiding. Yeah, and this is no. That's pretty much what built my memory up, in a way that benefits me very, very much in the future for not only, school-wise, but doing full-length movies. You know, I guess if I wanted to get into that profession, that would benefit me more than greatly, I guess. But I started off at 3 years old, and I made my first film. I never actually finished it, but I know I actually don't talk to these people anymore. But I made my first film at 13, and it was a spoof. Well, technically a remake with a whole different storyline. Based upon a video game called Resident Evil, my camera angles, I had no idea how to work my camera angles. I would go around chasing, the characters, the actors, with going like this, shaking, and everything would just be all shaky and groggy. My acting was terrible. We had no scripts. We just thought of it on the spot. And it wasn't until I was 14 where I actually started filming. You know, I got my hand on my digital camera at 13. That's the first thing I started. I didn't really keep it consistent as I did when I was 14 and now. When I was 14, I started doing video game videos. I was very into video games when I was younger. Pretty much this whole documentary would be going into a timeline on how I started and how I elevated from from what I used to do. Well, pretty much I started off just doing video game videos with commentary. Pretty much doing walkthroughs, showing steps on how to beat the video game, how to you know, just doing funny commentary with it. I guess I had this sense of humor where I would just splur out random stuff, you know, stuff that you would see on South Park, you know, with idiotic voices. And it was, you know, I did that for a while. I actually did a walkthrough on the video game Resident Evil. And, you know, I look back on it, even though, you know, it was kind of nerdy. You know, some people will look at it as nerdy. I look at it as a stepping stone for me. Pretty much just, you know, helping me out with my commentary, period. Just the fact that just my speech in general. You know, I would explain, just the way that I would explain, just like I'm doing now. I'm explaining my steps, the way that I film, the way I look at film, it's just, you know, it's more than just, you know, a video to me. It's more than just a movie. You know, I feel like it's my life. Some people use music. I use music as well. I do rap. Yes, you know, it's not as consistent as filming for me. It's more of just a hobby. It's more of just a vocabulary phase, you know, to help me, you know, build up my skills in screenwriting, my skills in composing my own music. And also it's like poetry to me. Just like screenwriting, making films, it's like poetry to me. It's like it's art. It's all art to me. And that's what I respect mostly about filming, mostly about music in general. But mostly the whole commentary thing with the walkthroughs and the video game walkthroughs, it built up my speech and it got me known on the internet. And then I started doing things called machinimas, which was voice acting for video games. Pretty much it's just a word for cinema, but you're using a console-based, you know, like a video game system. You know, I would make up my own series, like I had one called Sinner's Dream, which was really popular. It's also what got my name known on the internet, mostly YouTube. That's mostly what I posted. I also have one called Forgotten Shadows. I also made other single video projects, those little Pixar movies, you know, type in a way. That's what it was like for me, except, you know, it was a full length, you know, video. You know, it's just my voice acting. You could tell that I wasn't great at acting, but you know, I entertained people with it. I look back on it, like I said, it's another nerdy phase. But like I said, it benefited me for my camera angles, yes, and because I was actually capable of fixing my camera angles when I really couldn't in real life. It taught me a lot, you know. It helped me out with pretty much anything. I can make any character. I was able to, create a storyline anywhere, like Grand Theft Auto, be it Halo. You know, I would use all those games. You know, I would somehow create a storyline from it. I would somehow create, write, think of an idea in my head, and then I would just redo it with the microphone. My camera angles, you know, they elevated, they got better and better, and I did that for about maybe a year or two, until I actually stopped doing those completely. I actually put up public service announcement to, you know, the people that actually watch my videos on YouTube. A lot of them were upset until I actually started coming out with videos that I actually started acting in, because I felt like it was time. If I really wanted to become an actor, what if I really wanted to become a director or a producer, I had to take it to the next level, and I actually had to prove myself, because that's not going to get my name known to the public, you know. Like if I were to do it at the Tribeca Film Festival, which I will I will be posting a video, and I'll be explaining about that in a couple of minutes. I started doing a video. My first actual real life video was a script that my friend wrote. You know, just to be, you know, just as a stupid, you know, just as a stupid little marijuana comedy type thing like Seth Rogen would do. I would take oregano. I took the oregano and I took, like, you know, printing paper, and like, you know, it showed, like, in the beginning, like, you know, me lighting the printing paper up as if it was a joint, and you know, it would just be like a little stupid comedy sketch, you know. You know, it was a good start. You know, I edited the script every now and then. It was a good start. And then, you know, I just eventually my ideas just started rolling.